We're going to look at how we can survive knife attacks aside from just running away. That's your primary response, but that's not always feasible. It may be that you have to stay here to protect somebody else that he's coming out after with the knife. You may be in the protective role, and he's wanting to kill you to get to them. And if you're in the protector role, okay, now you can't just run away. So, not a likely situation, but these are some skills that you may need in, or may just have an interest in practicing in the realm of martial arts. So, the idea here is that we're going to work on something called tapping. This works pretty well against somebody who's doing stabbing motions. Tapping, you want to hit the hand or the arm, not the knife, and release quickly so that there's not a lot of stick to the feel. There's tapping and there's sticking. The sticking works better for slashing. Once they start into that, sticking is good to practice, and Chi Sao type exercises are good for that. Because that enters you into a lot of bridging and disarming and stuff. But with this kind of a knifing motion, tapping works better. So he's coming in for stabbing. And that is tapping. So when he's stabbing, you want to work on that. Stabbing, just keep coming. There you go. This is the drill. And he's already going, I don't want to keep swinging at him. Because it's painful. I'm slapping hard. With a partner, slap open the hand like I was with him. But in the air on your own, you can practice again with knuckle wrapping as well, because that's even more painful. And that can, if you hit the right places on the arm or the wrist, can make them drop the knife. At the very least, it will make the stabs more sluggish so that you may get to a point where you can bridge into disarms. So we're working on tapping until I get to a point where I can actually make a solid connection, because he's getting exhausted from the stabs and the pain from the taps. Now here are some things you can do to try to get the disarm. Smack down hard with the knuckles onto the radial nerve. That tends to make the hand release. Smack back of the hand hard. Nice. You may try to distract where his attention is and take it, or disarm it. Again, this is a grip that I showed in a previous video. So, again, don't just grab the knife. You're liable to lose the thumb there. Practice the palm, fingers to the opposite edge, little space on the top grip until you can do that quickly and still get it. So we got the hand. These are just some different things you might do to get him to comply. Here's more of a movement that's just to make him drop to the ground. Get that in. Shuffle in with your whole body weight when you do that. Once he's stabbed and the body goes into shock, he's very liable to just hit the ground. So those are some of the things that I like to do to get a disarm, or to bridge into disarming techniques, to bridge into the catching, is to start with tapping.